Hey guys, Pie Guy Rules here, and I wanted to talk about something a little different today. You may or may not know this, but I'm actually pretty into video games, and there's kind of one topic that I've been thinking about a lot lately, and it is the new Pokemon games, Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and Let's Go Pikachu. Now, I have opinions on these games, but I'm not really too interested in talking about my actual opinions on them. I'm more interested in talking about the community's reaction to these games and why I personally think that a certain type of fan is being absolutely ridiculous and really, like, just stupid about the situation. So, I think that the hate around this game is absurd, and I want to clarify that by saying it's not the people who don't want to get this game, it's not the people who don't like this game, it's not even the people who have problems with mechanics in this game. I totally understand all of those perspectives. If this does not interest you, that's okay. If you think there are legit problems with this, that is also okay. I personally do agree that there are certain things that look questionable, like the whole throwing mechanic instead of actually battling wild Pokemon, and the fact that you can't evolve your Eevee, thereby kind of missing the entire point of having Eevee as a starter Pokemon. But my beef here is with the people who think that this game is ruining the franchise, or it's, this game is just, like, should not exist, or it's a huge misstep on Game Freak's part. The people that are just blowing this whole thing out of proportion. Not the people who have criticisms, not the people who don't like the game or don't want the game, but the people that, like, think that this game is just, like, an insult to the Pokemon franchise. I think that those people are acting ridiculous, and I think it's because you gotta look at this situation, right? And you gotta say, okay, how many Pokemon games have we had that are essentially the same thing? Red, blue, yellow, gold, silver, crystal, ruby, sapphire, emerald, fire red, leaf green, diamond, pearl, heart gold, soul silver, platinum, black, white, black 2, white 2, X, Y, Omega Ruby, Alpha Sapphire, the latest ones, Pokemon Sun, Moon, Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon. That's 23 games. Okay, let's even be generous and have that amount and say that it's, you know, it's about, what, 11, 12 games, something like that. In this franchise, that if you want classic Pokemon gameplay, you have all of those options out there, okay? We are not talking about a franchise like Metroid where, you know, Metroid got skipped a lot. There was Other M, which wasn't very liked very much, and then years and years went by before we got the announcement of Metroid Prime 4. And in between then, there was the announcement of Federation Force. People were mad because that series has not existed for years and years and years, and there's really not that many games in the franchise. I understand the hate and frustration there, but with Pokemon, there is so many games with literally the same type of gameplay. I don't mean to insult the games by saying they're all exactly the same, because each game does add and tweak things. Sun and Moon, did a big twist in not having gyms, but the gameplay has basically been the same with some additions and tweaks over the years. But it's still basically the same sort of game. They have not done a major, major overhaul of, like, battling mechanics, for example, or catching mechanics, even. They haven't done that. And so, to say that this game, like, shouldn't exist is just, it's frustrating because it's not a franchise that is losing anything here, especially because there's going to be new games that are exactly the same, or not exactly, but almost exactly the same. They're in the exact same formula as the classic Pokemon games, as the standard Pokemon games, coming out next year. We're not going years and years without Pokemon because of this game. I think the whole it's a spin-off argument is one that makes sense in some contexts and doesn't in others. I think Federation Force, regardless of what that game actually was, I think people had a right to be upset because that is obviously not what they wanted from the Metroid franchise. And it's almost an insult to give them that instead of what they wanted. That's why I think people kind of have a right to be upset. Now, I think definitely people went overboard in that situation. But I am a lot more lenient on that because you could say that instead of a mainline Metroid series being developed, a game being developed, that got developed instead. Whereas with this, you can't say that. It's not taking anything away. It's like the whole Smash Brothers character slot argument, where having certain characters does not necessarily mean that other characters didn't get in. Dark Pit did not cost, you know, a whole brand new character from the ground up, because Dark Pit is obviously required a lot less development time than an entirely new character that isn't essentially a modified clone. So basically, that's kind of like my thing, is just that classic fans are getting what they want anyway. That's something that is just upsetting to see people think that, for like, okay, what, it's delayed a year, maybe we would have gotten a traditional Pokemon game. But really, the big thing that gets me is that the games have been so similar to each other, and this is the first time they're really doing something different in what is like a halfway between a main series game and a spin-off game. We've had tons of spin-off games that did things differently. We've had Colosseum and XD. We've had Detective Pikachu, which is just something entirely different. But we haven't really seen a big, big mix-up in the formula like this one is. And I do think that even if this game ends up being a flop, I think that being able to, A, have a game that probably required less dev time to be able to be put up on the Switch as kind of maybe like a demo, like kind of like how X and Y was not quite like a full fleshed out experience in the post game and everything, never got a third version, anything like that. And X and Y ended up seeming to be like a prototype for Sun and Moon. Like, it just kind of tested out the graphics and all that. So these games are going to be able to do that for the Switch. I think they're going to be able to test out maybe some online infrastructure, some new stuff that they might be doing with the series. And I think it's enabling them to test out some things without fully committing to them, which is good. The series just needs to experiment at some point, because I don't think I really want to buy another standard Pokemon game. And I know I'm just one person, but I'm sure there's other people in my situation that have bought all the games previously and at this point are just like, you know, I played it. Okay, cool, new Pokemon, sure, whatever. You know, Sun and Moon, I didn't buy Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon. And regular Sun and Moon, I played it, I enjoyed it, I loved it at the time for about 2 months, and then I moved on. And, I mean, hey, that's a lot more than I give most games. That's not an insult, but my time with the games, I feel like, is going to get less and less unless they do something radical with it. So I find that people that are just so against any change, it's infuriating. How do you want the series to evolve and grow? No pun intended there. You know, how do you want, or do you literally just want the same games every year? You know, here's token 60 new Pokemon, here's token graphical upgrade, new region that copies a lot of things from another region. Is that what you want as a Pokemon fan? Do you really just want that? Those basically not entirely insubstantial updates, but updates that ultimately don't change the way Pokemon is played? Because I sure don't. I don't want the franchise to be that stagnant for that many years. So yeah, that's kind of my thoughts on the scenario. And if you have criticisms with the game, that is totally understandable. If you don't think this game is for you, totally understandable. But if you think that this ruined your childhood, or you think that this is just like insult upon all insults to you, the Pokemon fan, just grow up, honestly. So yeah, let me know what you guys think, and if you want me to do maybe more videos like this in the future. With that, Pie Guy Rules out.